Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming today. I'm Takao Indo, working for Fujitsu. And today, I'm talking about the enhancement of Neutron for enterprise usage. And here is a table of contents of this slide, this presentation. First of all, I'll explain the background about Fujitsu's contribution to OpenStack. And next, I'll show you Fujitsu's activity to OpenStack, focus on Neutron. And I choose four topics here, network server active, and security group, firewall as a service, V2, and network traffic logging. And conclusion, I summarize this presentation and talk about the future plan. So background, for a long time, Fujitsu has provided on-premise system for customers to support their mission-critical business. And the most famous on-premise system provided by Fujitsu is Arrowhead. Arrowhead is a Tokyo Stock Exchange's trading system. And here is some phrase I got from the Arrowhead web page. It says that the Arrowhead use mission-critical IE server, Prime Quest, and Linux. And it also uses ultra-high-speed data management software, which allows data access on the order of microseconds. And also use high-reliability database management software. So from our experience of on-premise, we have learned what is important for mission-critical system. And first of all, RAS, this means the reliability, availability, and serviceability. This is very important to need. This is needed to realize non-stop, non-downtime system. And in the case of non-enterprise system, if problem happens, we can just stop the service and just reboot system or just replace broken hardware. It is not easy. It is either easy, but as to enterprise system, we cannot stop the service even if any problem happens. And another important point is troubleshooting. This is important to find the root cause of problem and fix it as soon as possible. And we need to collect as many data as possible when problem occurs. And if some problem, in the case of enterprise system, when problem happens, we need to reproduce the problem to investigate the root cause of problem. But from our experience, our customer does not allow us to reproduce the problem because we have to recover the system as soon as possible and to continue their service. Therefore, we have no chance to reproduce the problem for investigation. So the important point is we have to collect as many data as possible so that we can investigate it later. Sorry. And yes, there is another important feature, performance or scalability, security. Of course, this is important. And now we focus on cloud system as well as on-premise. And we have implemented OpenStack to realize enterprise system for not only on-premise, but also cloud. And Fujitsu provide cloud system K5. It's a next generation cloud platform. And here's also some phrase from website of K5. It says that K5 is a universal platform consolidating workload to increase operational efficiency. And it's open platform and maximizing interoperability integration of legacy systems with new technology. And this is also enterprise class availability and performance predictability across the technology stack. And the same quality as on-premise is required from the cloud system. So the discussion point is how we can realize it on the cloud system. To realize the enterprise system on cloud, there is a significant hurdle. The first point is OpenStack has a modular architecture. It consists of interrelated components loosely coupled. So this is more complicated than on-premise system. So this picture is a structure of OpenStack. Can you guys see this picture? There is the top of box is maybe keystone, and the center box is Nova, and left, the right one is, I think, Neutron. Anyway, this is a very complicated system. And OpenStack supports multi-tenancy, so we cannot stop each service, each server for maintenance because the different customer systems are working on the one server. And OpenStack network is highly virtualized, so it is not easy to investigate the network problem. So again, how realize enterprise cloud system on cloud? We have evaluated OpenStack to realize enterprise class from some point of view, like loss or troubleshooting, performance, scalability, and we found some point to be improved. And in this presentation, I introduced some of our challenge and future plans focused on Neutron. First of all, I'll talk about the Neutron server active. This is important to remove single point of failure. Here is a URL about the detail of this architecture. And to realize Neutron server active, HA is eventually realizing the controller node redundancy. And this picture is a very rough overview of active architecture. Here is the three controllers, and each controller has same server like Neutron server or Keystone server, something like this. And if user send a request, like an API request, one controller receives the request, and HA proxy deliver the request to one of the server. And if the controller goes down, another controller take over. And our challenge is evaluate Neutron server active feature to confirm this feature is really ready for enterprise system. And as a result, we found 10 problems, and all of them were fixed in the Neutron cycle. And here is a very easy example problem what we found. And for example, here is a two user, and they are in the same project, and they tried to create the same security group rule in the same security group at the same time. And the expected behavior is that the second request should be failed with a message like security group rule already exists. But actual behavior is that both requests are succeeded and two same rules are created in the one security group. So we fixed this problem by moving validation code to check deprecation into DB session. And next topic is security groups. Security group is a feature to filter packets. It filters ingress egress packets, and it works on port like this picture. And security group uses a whitelist for filtering, and it's stateful based on IP tables. So there is a problem about the security group performance. The problem is many security group rules cause performance degradation of the network. And this is very serious in especially multi-site environment. For example, there is a three data center, and each data center has its OpenStack environment. And to communicate with virtual machine in other OpenStack environments, security group rule to allow access between them are necessary. So the number of rules are increased according to virtual machines, a number of virtual machines. And multi-site feature is very important for enterprise system. For example, it is used to back up the system. So this is one problem we need to resolve. So our challenge is improve performance using IPsec. And the first, the box in the picture is a security group, command option security group rule. And here is the three rules. And in the current implementation, just convert one security group is to one rule, rule of IP tables. And a new implementation which we are working on is integrate the same rules into one IPsec group. IPsec is already used to implement remote group IDs, and so this is the same idea. And this is just internal optimization of IP table rule, so this is not change any API or interface. And this about this the current status of this idea, we have opened the bug and under the development. And as a future plan, we finish this implementation and merge it in Okata cycle. The next topic is firewall as a service version 2. Here's a rough overview of firewall. It is also a feature to filter packet, like security group rule. So there is a, but this is a similar to security group, but there is a two big difference between security group and firewall. The first one is firewall is applied to router, and security group is applied to port. And basically, firewall is for north-south traffic. The second is firewall has a whitelist and blacklist, but security group is only whitelist. That is a big difference between security group and firewall. And there is a problem of firewall as a service. The problem is the firewall as a service does not work with DVR. Before I explain the problem, I'll show you the overview of DVR. DVR means a distributed virtual router. And each component, each compute node has a virtual router. And this picture is explain the behavior of packet without DVR. If we don't have the DVR, the packet from the virtual machine is sent to the network node first, and then the packet will routing like this and send it to the target host, target virtual machine. And if we enable DVR, the virtual machine, a packet from virtual machine is sent to the router in the same computer node, and then sent to the each target virtual machine. So this, if we enable the DVR, network router in the network node does not use in the, like this case. And the problem of the firewall as a service is the stateful packet filtering does not work with DVR for east-west traffic. So say that the red arrow in the picture is the request packet, and the blue one is the reply packet. And the request packet go through the router in node 1 and send to the virtual machine 2. And the reply packet, the blue one, try to go through the router in node 2, but reply packet is denied here because the firewall in node 2 does not know that this traffic. Only firewall in node 1 knows this traffic. So that is the reason why the stateful filtering doesn't work. And to solve this problem, new API, firewall as a service version 2, is under developing. The new API firewall is applied to the port like security group. So stateful filtering work correctly as well as security group. In this picture, the red one is the request packet and sent to the virtual machine 1 to virtual machine 2. And the reply packet also sent to the virtual machine 2, from virtual machine 2 to virtual machine 1. So this is the filtering work correctly, the same as security group. And Fujitsu is contributing to firewall as a service version 2 as a core developer. The Yushiro Furukawa, he's here. He's working for this feature as a core developer. And the current status of this feature, implement the L3 part is implementing. And as a future plan, implementing CLI and GUI and L2 part. And also logging feature. I'll explain the detail in the next page. And the last topic is network traffic logging. The network traffic logging is important for user to detect network problem as soon as possible. And this picture shows the flow of packet. And there is a three packet, red one, and green one, and blue one. And the red one is denied in firewall. And red one is denied at security group. And blue one is allowed by firewall and security group and sent to the virtual machine. And so we need to log which rule allows the packet and or denied packet to investigate the network problem. And as I said, network is a bit highly virtualized by Neutron, so this feature is necessary. And this is also useful to confirm each firewall rule or security group is set up correctly. And this is an overview of network traffic logging we are implementing. And the user enable or disable this feature via API. And the resource like security group logs or firewall logs is created by the API. And if this feature is enabled, the driver, they are in the agent, the driver set up the IP tables to collect, to log the filtering. And log data is written in the syslog. And another component, collector, this retrieves the log data from syslog and separates the data to each tenant. And each log data is user can see their logs using like Monasca or something like that. So here is an example output. The red part is we call the prefix. It includes the log ID and action. Action means accept or drop. And it also in and out information. This is a Neutron port information and. Also include the packet information like MAC address or source IP, destination IP. And current status, the spec is under review. We are implementing security group logging. And future plan we support firewall logging as well and also support the mechanism and user interface so that each tenant user can get their logs. The conclusion, I have introduced some topics which Fujitsu has contributed. Neutron server active. We evaluated and fixed up some bugs. And security group, we propose the idea to improve performance, and this is work in progress for Okata. Firewall as a service version 2, contributing to realize it for Okata. And network traffic logging, we propose this as a new feature and work in progress for Okata. And last, I explain our future plans. And one of the plan is supporting rolling upgrade. As I explained, the OpenStack support multi-tenancy. That means the different customer virtual machine are working on one server, so we cannot stop the server easily. And on the other hand, user want to upgrade OpenStack system to use the latest feature. So we need to mechanism to upgrade online without downtime, like Kiro to Mitaka or Mitaka to Neutron. And in the Neutron side, to realize rolling upgrade, there are some feature is missing, like API micro versions. So we need to implement such a missing feature for Neutron. And another plan is support more features for bare metal. As to Neutron, for example, security group for bare metal is needed, but currently not supported. So we need to realize it. And regarding the bare metal, Taku Izumi will explain the detail in this room the next, from 3 p.m. After this session. So he will explain the detail about our activity of bare metal. OK, that's it. Thank you. So any question and comment? Well, I'll stay in this room, so if any problem, please come to me and please ask me directly. OK, thank you very much.